Check it, check, 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 mic, check, mic, check. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, troops, wherever you are in the world, and welcome back to the channel, Mark. That's me, my words, where we follow trading, traveling, and training. As always, before we do get into a very quick video, please continue to hit that subscribe button down there. If you do enjoy the content, don't forget to give me a thumbs up. Cheers, troops. Tell you what, door's open. I normally have it closed, and I've just seen it in the background, and it's put me off. There you go. Anyway, here we are, troops. Friday, 26th of August, 2022, the last trading day of the week, which saw the launch of APE, the preferred equity for AMC. But we'll get onto that in a minute. We got a bit to cover today. A couple of things I want to share with you, which I think are worth checking out, independent of what I say. And then my theory on AMC, which may surprise some people. So let's get into it then. GME, not a good week, I'm afraid. It has been a downward trend all week. We've been hammered down. The market has not been great. It's kind of been really like low volume week. I was looking yesterday, and you know, it was in the afternoon in America time, so it was not far from market close, I don't think. Maybe an hour or 2 hours before market close. And the volume was at like pre-split level, like less than a million shares. So it's really, really dried up this week for whatever reason. I think J Powell is speaking today. Maybe that's got something to do with it. Maybe some people are waiting to see what he says in his speech. So we'll see. But you can see clearly on the chart, we have broken out of this rising level of support there, going all the way back to the 11th of May. Obviously, these prices have changed in line with the split, but that rising level of support has been broken. Now we're in a downtrend. We did test it a couple of times. We've had a couple of fake breakouts, but nothing too spectacular. So it is what it is, troops. And on that, actually, I just want to show you this. Anybody who's on Superstonk knows Marantz and knows Austin, known as A Tobit. Sorry, Austin, not sure how to pronounce your surname properly. Does a lot of great DD. Marantz, I've just found his channel, actually. Enjoying watching him and getting his take on things. But go and watch this video. They have a very good discussion, especially towards the end. Austin talks about his theory of them trying to get it back down below old money, $120 for some reason. I can't remember the exact reason, but he does mention that, and that piqued my interest. I listened to that. I kind of looked up as I was doing other stuff and listening to it at the same time. And we are getting there, troops. $30 now in new money is $120. So, you know, there could be something behind that. Do go and check it out. Let me just move myself here a little bit. And then you can see the title. Whee, there we go. I'm over there now. Look, how good is that? It's called GameStop DD with Austin Tobit, Marantz Rants. Go and check that out. It's a very, very good watch. I thoroughly enjoyed watching all 2 hours and 20 minutes of that. And I don't normally sit through an entire video. So well worth watching on GME. Again, let's see what happens with the price. Psychologically, I want to talk about the psychology as well around these prices, because now we're at post-split prices, where if you think about it, when we were at, let's say we were at 120, okay, and you get a 10% swing, not that we've had a 10% swing, but you have a 10% swing, okay, all of a sudden you're down at what, $108, okay, It doesn't look too bad, and it doesn't sound too bad. I'm still $108. You know, you're still over that $100 mark, blah, blah, blah. And it's psychologically, I think it's less intimidating to have a $10 swing at that level than, say, if we are at $30 and we have a $10 swing and you start getting to $27, because all of a sudden that number, it's a lot closer to zero. And I'm not saying it's going to zero, don't get me wrong. I'm just saying psychologically, that number 27 is a lot closer to zero than what 108 is. Although the 10% swing is the same, it's a lot closer to zero. And also, you break down below a rounded 10 number. So you break down below 30, which then people start looking below that. Oh, where's the next support going to be? Is it going to be at 25? Is it going to be at 20? So you psychologically, people are taking themselves down already $7 looking for that next level of support. And it's the same with AMC and APE. Let me just put that put the charts back on. It's the same with AMC and APE. You know, psychologically, we're not at $18 anymore. I mean, we're not at $18 anyway. But that now that those numbers have split out, for me, the psychology kicks in, because that what once was at $18 is now $9.57 and $6.83. There are a lot smaller numbers. And it doesn't take long for people to emotionally and psychologically get caught in what is a relatively minor swing to the downside. So I'm really interested in the psychology of all this. That's what gets me excited. The strategy, the psychology, what are people thinking on that side, on our side, blah, blah, blah. So that's my take on it. I rely heavily on people like Austin, people like Trey, people, you know, who go and do the digging and do all the, you know, the DD stuff, far cleverer than I am, got a lot more time than I have, a lot more patience than I have, and just generally got a better brain than I have, to be honest. So I do read, I like to read the DD and then take away from it and go and do my own reading. But there's no way I could start knowing where to search and stuff like that. So I'm into the psychology and the price movement kind of thing on this. So with APE and AMC, another video which I think is worth watching. Let me just get it up here and show you that so you can have a look at that as well. Is this one. Let me just pause it there and get that screen back on there. There we go. And it's from Trey. And it's called Rico and Co's Theory on APE. And they've got a theory, again, well worth watching the video. They've got a theory that Adam Aron has created basically an avenue for hedge funds to exit while still, not that he's, you know, trying to orchestrate a squeeze, but a way in which short hedge funds would be able to exit without going, they'll still have to pay, but they won't have to pay as much. And they won't go out of business, whilst also APE and AMC go on a run. So that is another video that is really, really worth checking out. And I don't normally do this. I don't normally put out other people's content and say, go and watch it. Not because I don't want to support people. I do. I just think, you know, there's a lot of stuff out there that says the same thing over and over again. But these two videos particularly caught my attention for the theories. Personally, I'm gonna throw it out there. But personally, I think there's been some dilution already of APE. I really do. And that's my theory. For whatever reason, I just think, you know, the amount of shares that were traded at the beginning of the week, the fact that some people still don't appear to have APE shares in their brokerage account, you know, I think for me, it's a possibility. And I've not seen anybody or anything that's been able to persuade me otherwise. So that's my theory on it. Again, the price has been pretty stagnant over the last few trading days. So, you know, it's a watching brief, pre-market red on all three. We'll see what happens, troops. But a very, very, very strange week, but a couple of videos which I think you would do well to go and watch. A lot more informative than mine are. But again, as you know here, we look at price movement and psychology of it all. So that's it, troops. That's my take for today. I will be watching. I'm away. I'm going to another Volkswagen festival this weekend. Really looking forward to that here in Czech Republic. So I will get some videos out on that as well. Do look out for those. And that's it, troops. So as always, if you have enjoyed this content, please do give me a thumbs up. I've dropped a few subscribers lately. Not really sure why. I don't seem to have changed anything that I've done, or, you know, anything I'm doing. So give me a thumbs up. Help me get to the channel. I'd like to get to 1,000 subscribers before Christmas. That's my aim. So do spread the word. Help a brother out. And let's get on it. And without further ado, troops, wherever you are in the world, as always, do take care of yourselves and each other, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers, troops.